When most of us think about how digital photography has changed the medium, the first thing that comes to mind is Photoshop and the ease with which photographs can be digitally manipulated. I'm going to just talk a little bit about this. It's, I think, related to the question of the dematerialization of the photograph, which we'll of course we'll discuss that more later. So anyway, this is a recent example of a photograph that was circulated by email right after Sarah Palin was nominated, I got it in an email and really, I assumed that it was real, because she is a kind of a gun-toting beauty queen. Within a few hours, really, it turned out that it was, in fact, a hoax. It was Sarah Palin's head photoshopped onto the body of this woman in Georgia. And both of the original images were downloaded from Flickr. So someone just, put the two together. This is typically what people think of when they think of Photoshop and of how it's changed the medium and its relationship to truth. But this kind of thing has been going on for many, many years before Photoshop was ever invented. Another political example, this is a portrait of Abraham Lincoln. It was actually made right after the Civil War, after Lincoln's death, so it's a posthumous photograph of him. This was doctored pre-digitally. Lincoln's head was pasted onto the body of the Southern politician John Calhoun, who incidentally was very pro-slavery and pro-everything that Lincoln was against. So it was Calhoun's body. Then this picture of Lincoln's head by Matthew Brady, but flopped so that it fit the body, which you might also recognize from the old $5 bill. Now, this is not to say that there aren't real differences in how we create, look at, and understand photographs in the digital age, and I hope that during the discussion we'll be able to talk about some of these differences, some of the differences between seeing a photograph on a screen versus looking at an image on a piece of paper, whether it's a photographic print or a reproduction in a book or magazine.